Hello everyone, welcome back to our channel. Today we are going to learn about class 10 English unit 3 reading C, that is another woman poem glossary and question answers. Dear children, if you are new to my channel, please subscribe my channel, hit the like button and share it to your friends. Dear children, in this poem, the present poem Another Woman, which was written by Miss Imtiaz Darke. Here, Imtiaz Darke emphasizes the domestic violence which is happening against women all over India. Here, there are a lot of harassment, suffering, which is occurring in mother-in-law's house. So, the women suffered a lot in our India. Here, there are many women, not only one woman. There are many women who suffer, who are harassed by mother-in-law around India or at all over India. Now let us discuss about the poetess, the famous poetess, Miss Imtiaz Darke. Now let us know some more information about the famous and well-known poetess, Imtiaz Darke. Here, Miss Imtiaz Darke was born in Lahore in Pakistan in 1954, and she was born and brought up in Glasgow, Scotland. She is ranked on par with some of the famous women poets of India, such as Kamala Das, Sujata Bhatt, and Tara Patel. She is not only a poet but also a painter and an accomplished documentary filmmaker. Her collections of poetry include Purdha, Postcards from God, and I Speak for the Devil, The Terrorist at My Table, and Leaving Fingerprints. These are wonderful collections of poetry which were written by Miss Imtiaz Darke. Now let us know about the glossary of the present poem, that is Another Woman. Yeah, first one is here, Methi. It is a noun which means fenugreek. White radish, it is a noun which means white and round or finger shaped vegetable. Extravagance, it is a noun which means spending more than necessary in an uncontrolled way, spending more money on unnecessary items. Now let us discuss question answers of this poem. The woman thought of buying a white radish but later on decided against it, thinking it is an extravagance. Do you think it is an extravagance? Support your answer. Answer: normally buying a white radish is not an extravagance, but it is an extravagance for the woman. In the poem, first her mother-in-law always scolds her about their expenditure. Secondly, they are very poor, so the woman thought that it was unnecessary expenditure. Now let us switch over to second question. What does the phrase mother-in-law's dark looks suggest? Here in the poem, if we go through the entire poem, your mother-in-law used certain words. Her expressions is quite different. She didn't behave like a mother. She behaved like mother-in-law. She didn't take her daughter-in-law as her own sister. Here, her behavior is quite different towards her daughter-in-law. She never treats her daughter-in-law as her own daughter. Here, the answer is like this. The phrase mother-in-law's dark looks suggests that she is angry with her daughter-in-law. She never treats her daughter-in-law with love and affection. She thinks that her daughter-in-law is her natural enemy. Next question. The usual words came in bed. So the line which is extracted from textbook. Where did the words come from? Why? Answer. The words come from her mother-in-law. Mother-in-law scolds her saying that she spends extra money on unnecessary items. She also blames that her daughter-in-law's parents. She also blames and scolds her daughter-in-law's parents. And her words, mother-in-law's words, bet the young woman at she suffers in silence. Here, she is not only one woman. There are many women who suffered a lot, who are harassed by mother-in-law all over India. This is only a sample. Now let us see question number 4. Why did the woman crouch on the floor? The line which is extracted from the textbook. Answer: the woman crouches on the floor. That shows her modesty. Modesty means here simple. She never scolds her mother-in-law. She behaves very calm and quiet. She also expresses her obedience and submissive nature. She also tries to convey to her mother-in-law her position in that home. Here she didn't utter even a single word against her mother-in-law. She shows a very, very simple nature towards her mother-in-law. Now, 5th question. Why do you think the woman bent her back a little more when her husband came home? Was her husband helpful? Support your answer quoting from the poem. Answer: the woman bent her back a little more when her husband came home. This shows that he was not at all helpful to her. He was unconcerned about her feelings. He listened to his mother's harsh words, and he didn't say a single word. So she did not have faith in him. She has no right to speak in mother-in-law's house. So here she has no faith, she has no belief on her husband. So here she tortured, she was harassed by her mother-in-law a lot, even though her husband also didn't support her. Next question. What does the phrase "as usual" suggest? Here the phrase "as usual" suggests that the mother-in-law's scolding, the mother-in-law's usual words is common. It is not new and no hope it changed. She never changed the words which she uttered. So it they are very, very common. So actually here the scolding, the torture, the harassment of her mother-in-law is quite common. Next one, 7th one. The last line of the first stanza talks about the woman shielding her face from the heat. Shielding means here protecting or covering. Whereas the last line of the poem talks about people shielding their face from the heat. How are they different? In the first stanza, the woman shielding her face from heat. She tries to protect herself from the heat of the stove. The last line of the poem suggests that the people are turning their faces from the harsh realities of a society. Though the people know about the sufferings being faced by the women, no one comes forward to act against it. Next one, that is 8th one. So when the kerosene was thrown, who threw the kerosene? Why? Support your answer quoting from the poem. Answer: the woman herself threw kerosene. She suffered a lot in her mother-in-law's home. She had no hope of relief. She had only one choice, that was ending her life. So she burnt herself. So she submitted herself in the hands of the flame. Because here there is no escape. There is no chance to escape from the hands of the mother-in-law as well as her husband. So she wants to get complete relief from her mother-in-law's house. So that's why here she ends her life and she burnt herself in the hands of the kerosene flame. Now let us move on to another question, that is 9th one. What does the title "Another Woman" suggest? Answer: the title "Another Woman" suggests that she is only one of many women who suffer a lot. It indicates that the problem is much larger. The woman in the poem is a typical example of the woman who are imposed to the domestic violence. Here she is not only one woman, there are many women who suffers, who harasses, who was being faced domestic violence which was occurred against women all over the world. Now let us move on to last question, that is 10th one. Words do not have wings, but the author used them as if they had wings. The usual words came and bent their wings against. This is a literary device, figure of speech, called personification. Find out the other examples. Instances means here examples of personification in the poem. Answer. The poem has some examples of personification. They are, she watched the flames is up and wet against the cheek of the old pot. Here, the flames are lifeless. Here, the comparison made between two things. So, one is a lifeless. Understand? Here, her flames are lifeless. Yet, they hiss like a living being. Similarly, the pot is personified as having a cheek. And in a wing of brightness, brightness is personified as having a wing. So these are the two examples which are extracted from the poem. Now the last one, that is 11th question. In the story The Journey, the author used the journey as a symbol of life. You will find such symbols in the poem too. Pick them out and talk about them. Answer. The poem Another Woman has many symbols. For example, first one is, the title itself is a symbol of all suffering women. Second one, heat is a symbol of suffering, harassing, torturing and blame and scolding. Crouch is a symbol of obedience. Third one, dark looks is a symbol of angry or harsh behavior of mother-in-law. Usual words is the symbol of ill treatment of the girl. Fifth one, only choice is the symbol of there is no chance to live. So she submitted herself in the hands of the flame. Here sixth one, another torch is the symbol of another woman who is going to end her life in another house. So dear children, these are all question answers which are given at the end of the poem, that is Another Woman. So dear children, once again you need to go through all the question answers and understand carefully. I hope you understood all the question answers which are given in this poem. Thank you for watching my channel. If you are new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe my channel, hit the like button and share it to your friends. Thank you. Have a great day. Stay safe, stay secure, stay healthy.